You're my 9 o'clock, Mrs. Smith, yes. Okay. I've just got your file here from next door. And you're here for a near examination because you've been experiencing severe earache. Is that right? Okay. And have you been experiencing any dizziness or lightheadedness? Okay. And your ears look red. Have they been itchy? They have. Okay. I'm just going to write that down. Okay. What I'm going to do first is I'm just going to pop on my gloves and then I'm going to take a look inside your ears, both of them, with my otoscope. Do you have any pain or discomfort right now? You've just been taking ibuprofen, okay. So there's no pain at this moment. Okay. Well, if I do hurt you at all, then please let me know, okay. I'm just going to get a fresh head for my otoscope. There we go. And I'm just going to take a little look inside your ears to see what's going on. So, as I say, both your ears are very red and swollen. There's quite a big build-up of cerumen, which is basically earwax, oily wax. It's very good to have a little bit, as I say, just to keep out any foreign particles and dust and microorganisms. But because that you wear earplugs and headphones, then that has caused the compactment, obviously, of the earwax, which pushes it further down your ear canal towards your eardrum. And the body is supposed to naturally drain earwax, but because it's that compact, and especially as you get older, it gets more hard, then the more trouble it is for the body to clear itself of the wax build-ups there. That's why we need a little bit of help. So, microsuction, which basically acts like a vacuum effect to suck the wax out. Or we can break down the wax buildup with the chemical drops. But I just want to have a closer look inside both ears. I need a deeper look near your eardrum. So I'm just going to put a stronger strength microfine glass onto my otoscope, because I need to have a look at your eardrums to make sure there's no holes or perforation at the eardrum. Because if we find that there is some holes and you have a perforated eardrum, we won't be able to do the chemical drops, and we are going to struggle with the microsuction. But I'm just going to take a look, okay? Hold still, please. I'm just going to go right deep and down now. Let me know if I hurt you, won't you? I'm just going to pull down on your pinnae a little bit. Okay. It's very hard to see with all this compactment, and I don't want to hurt you. So there's definitely no signs of perforation or holes in the eardrum, so that means that we can go ahead with the chemical drops, which is brilliant. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to get the chemical drops together, and then I can put them into your ear, okay? So let me get this all ready for you. Okay, I've got a syringe here, and I'm going to make a solution, okay, in this bowl here, and then I'm going to put a little bit in each ear again, and you will experience quite a bit of fizzing and crackling and that sort of thing, which is to be expected, and that'll just be the chemical drops breaking up the wax, okay? So, right then, I'll bring all my stuff. Now procedure was done. Some tissue close by. Now, that's wonderful. I'm just going to write down what I've found, the outcome, the conclusion. Now, I would like you to come back in a week's time, okay? Just so I can have a look and see if the chemical drops have cleared up all the compactment of the wax in the cerumen, okay? Now, in the meantime, until you come back to the appointment, to use some almond oil twice daily until our next appointment, okay? Just to keep that wax built up at bay. Once you come back and you've had the appointment, if your ears are healthy and well, then what I advise you to do is use almond oil, put it into your ears at least once a week, and this will just keep all the cerumen, you know, at bay, leaving a little bit in, and it just all round keeps your ears healthy. Okay, do you have any almond oil? No. Well, if you go to the supermarket or the chemist, they sell it in there anyway. Okay, it's pretty easy to come by, and it's not too expensive, but it'll do wonders for your ears. Okay, but okay, well, I think that's it for today. So if you want to go through the double doors and go to reception, the main desk at the front, and then if you tell them that you want to make an appointment for a week's time, then they can book you in there. Okay, is there anything else that you'd like to ask me? I mean, if you want to keep taking your ibuprofen, if the pain does continue to incur, then that's absolutely fine. Ibuprofen's perfectly safe. But yeah, come back in a week's time, and then we can see exactly what's what. But if the chemical drops carry on doing the work, and keeps going as good as I saw inside your ear canal, then you shouldn't have any pain and you shouldn't have any problems. So, but as I say, if you just go to the front desk and then obviously ask them to book your appointment, and then I can see in a week's time, and hopefully you'll have clear ears. Okay then, you have a nice day.